The disgraceful history of the colonial period. A war torn between victory and defeat. The only thing remaining is a pain of division. The founding of a country in chaotic times. And the endless shift of regimes and ideological disputes. From the 1930s to the 80s, Korea was entangled in a whirlwind of changes.
저는 이 태어나면서부터 어떤 그 우리나라의 격변기를 다 겪었다고 볼 수 있습니다. 내가 살아온 그런 어떤 삶의 무늬 속에 한국의 격변기가 다 배어 있다는 거죠. 그런 그 고통, 고뇌, 우리 사회가 겪었던 일제시대부터 지금까지 우리 사회가 겪었던 고통, 고뇌를 다 몸으로 가만히 있어도 체험해왔다 이렇게 볼 수 있습니다.
김주영 writes about people who suffered for no apparent reason, just like himself.
Anyone would be most thankful to their parents for delivering them to this world. Our mothers and fathers are the only ones who would sacrifice themselves for us. His very piece that got recognition in a sudden gust from his readers was about our mothers and fathers.
His representative piece, The Roar of Thunder, takes place during the many changes in Korea. Through this piece, Kim Joo-young establishes himself as a representative writer during this period. He handles the theme of national tragedy by depicting the lives of people who seem to be alienated from this tragedy, but are in fact intricately linked.
가족의식. 이것도 전쟁에서 파괴되어 버렸으니까 그것을 찾아가는 어떤 과정 속에서 두 사람이 순수한 애정을 가지고 우리의 가족, 뭐 어미, 아비 이런 걸 찾아내는 그것이 무엇인가를 다시 한번 생각해 하는 그런 과정을 그렸다고 볼 수 있죠.
In the long run, the writer's focus is on his characters. And through them, he indirectly reveals the sorrows of the nation. His characters are not heroic or extraordinary, but are simple country folk, like Shin Gil-nyo from The Roar of Thunder and the common people around her. Though their lives surrounded the latter part of this history, their pain, both deep and destructive, should not have been ignored. People's lives that were torn due to the war had to go through a cruel punishment that they did not deserve.
직접 전장에 참여하지는 않습니다만은 전쟁으로부터 상처를 받고 인간성을 파괴당한 사람들끼리 어떤 겪는 그 애정 관계를 통해서 우리가 얼마나 전쟁이라는 것이 인간성을 훼손시키고 파괴하는 우리 삶의 전통적인 삶을 얼마든지 파괴하는가 하는 얘기를 신길려라는 아주 평범한 이름을 가진 한 여자의 행각을 통해서 제 딴에는 이제 고발을 한다 그런 심정으로 쓴 거죠.
Shin Gil-ryo goes through modern history laden with war, hunger, and ideological disputes with only the strength of her own body, representing our mothers and grandmothers. Kim Joo-young talks about the characters who live in the latter part of history, but who are actually at its center. A critic noted Kim Joo-young as a laboring novelist, While he writes 500 pages of work a month, he also does other work for 5 days a week and travels for at least the 2 days left of his week. He is a writer who learns about people in his travels and expresses their deep sentiments in his novels. In 1998, Kim Ju-young published the sensational The Skate, turning retrospectively to the space of his childhood in the remote countryside hills.
홍어도 역시 그 가족의 이야기라고 볼 수 있죠. 그래서 역시 저 지속적인 관심이 뭐냐면 가족이란 게 무엇인가? 우리는 어떤 곳에 정착을 하고 우리 삶의 그 풍요로움을 일구어 나가는가 하는 얘기를 하고 싶었던 거죠.
There can be no mother whose life does not concern herself with her child's life, but there can be an inner life inside her that her child does not or should not know about. The main theme in The Skate is a stubborn interest of the son towards his mother's deep feelings. A fickle father who left his family, a mother who waits for him, and a son who waits for his mother's love. What speaks for the mother's feelings of regret is the stingray kite. The image of the kite disappearing into the mountain ridges is similar to the image of the father who left his family, leaving his hat behind. Whenever the boy loses his kite, he feels pleasure towards it. And by making a new kite every time it gets lost, the mother assures her attachment toward her husband. Were the son and mother only waiting for the father every time they made and flew the kite?
그 이 연이 상징하고 있는 것은 어디든지 떠나고 싶은 그다음에 어떤 가족적인 혹은 사회적인 구속에서 벗어나고 싶은 그런 욕구가 이 연날리기에는 들어 있다고 보고 있죠.
The father returns after 6 years. But ironically, it is the mother's turn to leave. Despite her long wait for him.
Human 것은 그 다음의 세계, 또 다른 세계에 대한 어떤 그런 동경심이 있죠. 근데 그 또 다른 세계를 찾아서 떠났다. 또 한 가지는 오히려 돌아옴으로 해서 얻는 그런 성취감이 아니고 어떤 배신감 그것을 그런 행동으로 바깥으로 표출이 되었다 이렇게 봐야 되겠죠.
And what are we waiting for right now?
The beauty of Kim Ju-young's novels lies in this series of departures and seizures. Lives that drift around like grass and cannot stay in one place are in the midst of his pieces. In those lives, there's always some waiting, and sacrifice is hidden in that waiting. Kim Ju-young's candid and calm pieces are like a bond in our lives that continues even over the passage of time.